Finishing chapter 14 in ATI. Therapeutic procedures, which this is all regarding head injuries. A craniotomy could be performed, and it's the removal of a non-viable brain tissue that allows for expansion and or removal of epidural or subdural hematomas. It is also used to decrease ICP and remove brain tumors. It involves drilling a burr hole or creating a bone flap to permit access to the affected area. Treatment of intracranial hemorrhages requires surgical evacuation. There are three surgical approaches. You can have supratentorial, above the tentorial, infratentorial, below the tentorial, which is the brain stem, and transsphenoidal, which is through the mouth, and nasal sinuses. Burr holes are circular openings through the skull. The burr hole is used to assess cerebral swelling, injury, size, and position of the ventricles. This is a life-saving procedure and is associated with many potential complications, such as severe neurologic impairment, infection, persistent seizures, and neurologic deficiencies and death. Nursing actions with the craniotomy would be medications administering such as mannitol and dexamethasone, which can be administered every 6 hours for 24 to 72 hours post-op. Phentoin or diazepam can be used to prevent seizure activity. Monitor ICP, follow written protocols to assess for changes in ICP. For supratentorial surgery, maintain head of bed at least 30 degrees with body positioning to prevent increased ICP. For infratentorial craniotomy, keep client flat and on either side for 24 to 48 hours to prevent pressure on neck incision site. Calm and reassure clients, clarifying misconceptions. Brain surgery can be an extremely fearful procedure. Ensure professional care. Care should include professionals from other disciplines as indicated. This can include physical, occupational, recreational, and or speech therapists to neurologic deficits due to the neurologic deficits that can occur secondary to the area of the brain damaged. Contact social services or case manager to provide links to social service agencies and schools. Rehab facilities are frequently used to compress the time required to recover from a head injury and support reemergence into society. Complications that can occur is brain herniation. A brain herniation is the downward shift of brain tissue due to cerebral edema. The brain consists of brain tissue, cerebrospinal fluid, and blood. Due to the limited space within the skull, as alteration of any one of the components of the brain results in a compromise in the other components. When trauma creates a shift in these components and the other components are unable to accommodate, the brain shifts from the cranial vault or herniates. This can result in brain tissue moving downward through the foramen magnum. Findings include fixed dilated pupils, deteriorating level of consciousness, shiny Stokes respirations, hemodynamic instability, and abnormal posturing. Recovery after this occurrence is rare, and urgent medical treatment, mannitol, and or surgical debulking treatment is indicated. With treatment, severe neurologic impairment usually persists. Nursing actions are that this situation should be prevented before treatment is needed. Close monitoring of vital signs and neurologic status allows early reporting of changes in the GCS score, an increase in the blood pressure, and an alteration in respiratory pattern and effort. Frequently update family members on health status of the client. Frequent updates and repeating medical information is often necessary to ensure comprehension among family members. Client education. The decision to surgically treat brain herniation is made in the presence of a critical situation. Social service workers and or pastoral personnel can be helpful to support the family while reinforcing the medical situation. Another complication possibility is hematoma and intracranial hemorrhage. Monitor for severe headache, rapid decline in level of consciousness, worsening neurologic function and herniation, and changes in ICP. Surgery is required to remove subdural and epidural hematoma. Intracranial hemorrhage is treated with osmotic diuretics. Another complication is pulmonary edema. Findings mimic acute pulmonary edema without cardiac involvement. This is a life-threatening emergency. Immediate aggressive treatment is used. Survival is rare. Diabetes insipidus or syndrome of inappropriate antidiuretic hormone is another possible complication. Diabetes insipidus or syndrome of inappropriate antidiuretic hormone, SIDADH, is a possible complication. This is not type 1 diabetes, it's the third type. Nursing actions. Monitor blood electrolytes and osmolarity daily. Document strict INO. Weigh client daily. Treat electrolyte and fluid imbalance as prescribed and monitor for dehydration or fluid overload during treatment. This completes Chapter 14, ATI. Finish with the active learning scenario application exercises for study.